Hey, welcome to the 6 Inch Show, episode 115. Slightly new platform today. We kind of get caught up by Zoom deciding to charge us, and we haven't really had time to do anything else. But here we are on StreamYard. Let us know if there's any problems. I don't think there will be, but leave a note in the comments and let us know. Anyway, 115 of the 6 Inch Show, as you probably know, is Hasbro Star Wars, Marvel Legends, G.I. Joe, all that stuff. Joined, as ever, by Mr. Toy Tribe, Mr. Matt, Mr. Instagram himself.
Hello, welcome back.
Hello, hello. It's been a month, I think, since we did a show, ish. And then that little thing called San Diego Comic-Con 2022 came along. There was a lot of stuff, and there wasn't a lot of stuff. There was some okay stuff, some expected stuff. What we didn't actually add, which we were talking about earlier before, was there's a bunch of Star Wars new credit collection stuff as well, which we need to cover. Damn, I forgot about that. Being a lot of stuff. So we've got tonight to cover. We've got some selfie stuff from Star Wars, the reissues or second wave of the credit collection, Marvel Legends. There wasn't any official G.I. Joe picks from the. Was there? I can't
Well,
think.
there's the official shots of Sergeant Slaughter. There's Mindbender, which we'd kind of done before, I guess. Oh, there was also the photos of the Golden Serpent dude.
Serpentor.
That's the
Yeah, I think
one.
it. We'll pick up stuff as we go. There's a bunch of stuff. We may miss some bits and pieces as we go on. But yeah, San Diego Comic Con. I mean, from what I've seen, and we'll get into to more in a minute and go back and look at the last episode of the show. But just as a kind of overall condensed view of San Diego Comic Con for you, what did you think?
I think NECA won San Diego Comic Con.
They did, didn't they? They really did.
That's my takeaway from Comic Con,
Yeah.
is that NECA won it. And not that there's a winner, but if there was, it would be NECA. They just knocked some stuff out of the park, and it was exciting, and I could watch their stuff over and over again and find new things, or just things that just looked cool. And it was a bit of a mixed bag from everything else. I kind of feel like Hasbro is holding back. I don't think they held back with Star Wars. I think Star Wars got more than it had gotten all year, but it wasn't that exciting. And I still hope or think they're holding some stuff back for PulseCon next month across all
For sure. For
three
sure.
lines. Like, I mean, that's their show and that's their thing. So I expect to see more on both of those, from all three of those at that event. But as far as Comic Con went, it's kind of like NECA just to me was like, well, I want it all.
It's funny. I mean, I'd seen a couple of things prior to the show, so we knew some things were coming. Black Boba Fett and the Andor release, and a few other leaks that came out, which we didn't spoil. But I kind of just hope for a bit of a. You know, it feels like 6 months. You and I and most of the community have been saying Star Wars is just. You know, where's the love we talked about? It's just not been really. It's just not been doing a great job. And I really hoped, I thought San Diego Comic Con, they're going to reveal something really punchy for Star Wars. And we kind of, I unfortunately have COVID and I've been traveling to see some sick family and stuff. So I was kind of busy. So I was diving in and out. And really, the first stuff I saw was a lot of the repackaged, the credit collection and the Halloween Trooper. And I just thought, Jesus, here we go. I'm really at my wit's end with Star Wars, it has to be said. I'm now into deeply disappointed. I'm really hoping they can turn a corner. Really, really hoping, because I met a couple of people in the UK. Hello to you people there, and someone in Australia as well who was kind of, hey, watch your videos. We started job talking, and like 45 minutes later, we're still talking about Hasbro. And every one of them was saying the same thing, like basically, WTF Star Wars, what the hell? What is going on? So, it's spread everywhere. Everybody feels the same. So, bit disappointing. Marvel Legends was good. I think
Yeah,
there was some
I think
strong stuff.
it was decent. A lot of stuff, though, as we'll get to, goes over my head. Like it was San Diego Comic Con, the deep cut edition.
Yeah,
it was. You know, some stuff didn't, but a lot of the stuff there, I was kind of like, who, what?
Yeah,
oh, yeah, cool, but. Like, I mean, you know me and Spidey, there's a lot of things that I won't pass up on Spidey, particularly as I'm now focusing more on comic than MCU. And there was some reveals there apparently from Spidey where I'm like, yeah, no, I'm not doing that. But not because of what they were. It's just like it's so far out of my Spidey realm.
Yeah.
You know, I missed that. I wasn't born for that 1974 comic or whatever it was. I don't know.
Yeah, it gets a little specific in some cases. There was very little Power Rangers kind of reveals or anything. Maybe there's more post-con, but we'll skip that anyway. And we had some good stuff overall, but yeah, Star Wars, I think, was the weakest of the bunch. Anyway, we'll dive into that and get a look at it. There's a lot to cover. We'll miss stuff. We'll put some photo albums together. There'll be a link under this video to most of this stuff if you haven't yet seen it, which would be kind of bizarre. But if you haven't, we can pick that up. Lots of exclusives, lots of stuff all over the place again. So it was really hyper-confusing to... Where am I getting this thing? Where can I get this thing? Oh, it's sold out. It was just gone. The Venom pack, I think, was 1 hour from Go Live, the Marvel Legends 3-pack. I believe it was an hour anyway, which is just kind of nuts. And, of course, Amazon, we now know that the format for them, we're not supposed to talk about it, but we all know that pretty much Amazon puts stuff up, sells it immediately. They've obviously capped the pre-orders. 6 months down the line, as you and I were talking, suddenly it maybe slips out again on Amazon UK, Amazon Australia, and other countries quietly with no fanfare. They have stock. It's just kind of bizarre. This is exclusives for you. This is the way it works. So, a bunch of stuff. A bunch of stuff to go over and look at. We'll get some photos officially from Hasbro. Some which they never gave to us, which were just kind of released. Credit to him. Toysha's wonderful YouTuber. He got something revealed, which was great, that the blue retro Spidey. But then Hasbro didn't do a press release for it, which is very odd. So it's all a bit patchy and a bit weird. So hence why, bear with us as we put things together for San Diego Comic-Con. First and foremost, let's get a look at the last show very quickly, 114, and your guys' comments. And excuse any technical brain farts as we kind of share stuff here. I share stuff. Let me share the window. So let's go to the episode 115, or 114, I should say. And you should be seeing this on screen.
In the small thing, like, yeah, anyway.
Is that better? Is that better?
I can't see. I can't, but I'm sure the screen can. You just read it. It's all good.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's showing up all right. So anyway, so 114, what you guys were commenting on was pretty much the Hiss Tank, and everybody seems to absolutely love it. As Clay Heiklinen says there, three figures, the driver, technician, female gunner, and probably more.
No, there's four. We got it wrong. We got it wrong as in there's... We were talking about all of them. The early bird one. Then there's the... driver, the female driver, and then there's still the other one, which is going to be a color choice. Wow. I don't know what it is, but I think there's going to be four figures to it.
It's a phenomenal HasLab. It really is something incredible. It's just, I mean, what a success story this one has been. Even more than Galactus, I would say. It's just been, just for the add-ons, the sheer kind of...
Are you talking about Reaver's double lightsaber?
Star Wars team, what in the hell were you doing?
I'm blaming Lucasfilm. I'm blaming.
Yeah, absolutely. Lucasfilm, definitely. I think, as we've said in just about every episode, has a bit of a blame in this one. So it's not all Hasbro. God. Yeah, they're not having a great time, the Star Wars team, unfortunately. Lucasfilm is deciding stuff. Colonel Angus was saying he was doing the show. talking about G.I. Joe, blah, 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 blah. Appeal to more fans, get more backers. I agree. He did pretty much everything we were talking about before. Each turn Ray was saying, remember, Matt, you're the one that gave Hasbro the idea for the next HasLab with the mod gang. Do you know, it wouldn't surprise me. The way things are going, it wouldn't surprise me if they announced that. That would just be... Oh,
that would be the end of it.
That would be the end of it, I think. It really would be. So, is a good example again. Jason S., after nearly 2 years of fighting off the GI Classic Food Series collecting bug, his tank got him. So, you know, phenomenal release. Real fan pleaser. And all the extras just absolutely tickled the parts for many.
So, just to confirm, you're going to get the driver. Then you're going to get the female driver. Then you're going to get a brand new Cobra Commander.
Yes, the retro one. Then
you're going to get the one of the 6 chosen colored tacticians.
Which was the vote. I think there was a vote earlier on.
A vote for which one of the 6 will get there kind of thing, yeah. So it's 4 figures with the Hiss Tank. So that's $25 a figure. That's $299, but it's basically for $199 and 4 figures that you can only get from this.
I just think I have to I have to pre-order this. There's no, it's really big, it's really expensive. I don't need it, but the sheer value alone and the figures that you can't get anywhere else yet. They just done a phenomenal job in that HasLab. Applause to the G.I. Joe team. Absolutely stunning. After a bit of a shaky start, and then they kind of switched to retro everything, and it kind of on track. Really, really good job.
They turned it around quickly.
They did, didn't they?
There's no 2 years. They turned it around within about 6 months.
Yeah. Anyway, let's quickly go back and finalize off these comments. Everyone's loving the Hiss Tank. People are not necessarily... Oh, well, there you go. Someone bought the sci-fi, a good Star Wars reviewer on YouTube. He bought the Kristan figure. Then he says, that's going to be a repaint from me. So, yes, not a great figure. Christopher Miller, he's like in some aspects... he bought about 30 Black Series Maz Kanata figures when they're in clearance at $3 each and converted them to Jawas. Wow. Okay. That's one way to go. That's a customizing job for you. Chris Fortemeyer was saying, when you look at the only two Black Series figures from throwing the Book of Boba Fett, I should say, Fennec and Boba, both could easily have been Mandalorian box figures, change the packaging to have the show, to have some representation. I absolutely agree. It is an odd one. We were talking about the last show, yeah. That weird. Palpatine 1975, his tank is backed. Good, says Palpatine. Uffy Key, also I think the difference between a Star Wars HasLab and another franchise HasLab is that insane fee they have to pay Lucasfilm licensing. Yeah. Can't believe a cardboard backdrop, some bones, etc., all as their creative minds can muster.
I'm just going to say one thing. And I don't know what the licensing is, but I do not think that the license is that different between Marvel and Star Wars.
But then again, there's the majority is comic based, which is historical, so it's probably a hell of a lot lower than movie based.
It's percentage based. License is a percentage based of thing, and I think they sit pretty close to each other.
But then again, as we've talked about before, Star Wars is pretty much, well, nearly most figures are brand new sculpts or brand new elements, whereas Marvel, we can even see tonight, it'll show a lot of them are reused, so there's a big cost.
You know, 100%, but that's from the licensing point of view, the licensing is licensing, whether it's
true.
Hasbro, Disney, the Beatles, whatever it is. When you're doing licensing deals, there's a certain amount you have to pay, and it's not like Star Wars is sitting there at 46% and everyone else is at 20. They're all pretty close to each other.
Yeah. So again, just to finalize off on all your thoughts, people, the Kenneth Curley Jr., Mr. 114 show commenter, was back as well, talking about he's still loving his DC Multiverse 7-inch figures, which technically aren't 6-inch, Kenny, but I agree that they just, McFarlane still killing it with a lot of stuff. Warhammer and DC Multiverse, some stuff is pretty good. They are slipping into a lot of the kind of samey stuff again, lots and lots of Batman figures, but yeah, there's some good stuff. Haslabs, he backed the saber. I really do want it, but just as a generic Inquisitor saber. His tank, he ordered two. Well, that tells you exactly what you need to know about Haslab stuff. Christopher Miller is asking, Kid, Luke, and Leia, do you guys think Hasbro will make Black Series versions of them for the line? I don't think so. If they ever do, it would be a comic version, I think.
Which one was this for? Sorry?
Kid, Luke, and Leia, a child version of Luke and Leia.
I think they'll make a child version of Leia. I don't think they'll.
I agree with you, yeah.
A kid version. They won't make a Luke. Not that kid.
Yeah.
Two scenes. The other, Leia was in the whole series.
I think that window has gone, though, I think, for her, but I'm right.
It can always turn up as the, you know, how they do it now at the saga. You can have three from this, one from that, and just
Sure. Racetrack is a couple of corrections on some of the stuff we mentioned. Yeah, I'd seen this before. The Apocalypse's animated series version, not comic. Yes, you're right, my apologies.
But not cel shaded.
But not cel shaded. The one thing that annoys me about Cobra Commander is he won't have his hood as an option. Cobra Commander's hood?
Yeah, they've got the Cobra Commander used to wear a hood, but it's a bit clanny.
Yeah, so that's all. Yeah.
They're not doing it.
I know what you're talking about. Yeah, the cloth over his head. Yeah. It's a little weird, that version, but yeah, fair enough.
You could get a custom from Old Boy. I'm not sure if they're still selling it now, but they were doing it last month.
Oh, there you go. I know Matt will say Slavely is not banned, but multiple sources have confirmed it. What sources? Anyway, we've not seen Slavely in any media. Well, I mean, everything's now instead of Slave One, it's Boba Fett's starship. So, yeah, I think Disney or anything with the word slave they don't like. So, yes, there is a bunch of changes that Disney are making to things slowly but surely. But, yeah, I don't think anyone's too heartbroken anymore. But I remember when the whole, you know, oh, they're not calling it Slave One, boycott Disney, boycott Star Wars, that had an impact. Not. Sure showed them. Yeah, I know.
First thing they did was fire Kathleen Kennedy.
Nobody likes change. It kind of sucks sometimes, but it is what it is. Okay, so San Diego Comic Con 10 days ago or something. This is the first chance we had to catch up. Let's go over and have a look at this stuff. There's a bunch of bits and pieces to share. Let me just call up a bit of a... it's actually quite a good overview here. The Toy Arc girls and boys had a nice page because I wanted to show off some of the box art as well, which some of the pictures didn't quite get or we didn't have there. But let's use this as our little... sheer piece. Let me bring this and just here a little bit more and we'll share. Share screen and off we go. So you should hopefully on screen. Yeah, you will minimize it.
Yeah, just make that bigger.
Yeah. I'm kind of, let's minimize us a little bit there and you should see this more. So we got a bunch of stuff. They've done a good job of wrapping some of the stuff. We obviously have the Halloween Trooper. There's a bunch of vintage collection stuff in here. We're going to skip through some of them, but yeah, there's quite a few bits and pieces and figures here. Black Series Axe Wolves, which we were really desperately needing to complete the set. The Credit Collection bunch, a lot of which was exclusive. Ahsoka Tano, Boba Fett, Bo-Katan, the Dark Trooper, the Mandalorian Tatooine version, and a Tusken Raider made up that set. Bit of a hard thing to swallow to get a Credit Collection Dark Trooper, for example, when you haven't even got the damn Dark Trooper yet, really, or many people haven't. The same for Ahsoka, which is just a fresh figure. But
I'm just going to go here once again, and this is my major gripe with this kind of decisions. We'll keep it friendly. How do we go to a Credit Collection Tusken Raider without going to a Book of Boba Fett Tusken Raider? Like, we don't even need the key character one, just a tribal one with the black cloth and the black paint. But let's go to a silver, shiny, unimaginative, boring Credit Collection Tusken Raider that just doesn't even appear in any of the credits and all that stuff, appearing like this. But anyway, we're now going to a Tusken Raider where you still haven't done a Book of Boba Fett Black Tribal Tusken Raider. And if you just wanted to reuse this mold and give it its black and red kind of designs without even going to that key character and that key member, but just the tribe. And here we are wasting this sculpt, this mold, and this release as reuse, as a credit collection. It's just boring.
And this is what now the 1, 2, 3, 4.
Who
five,
even cares? It's the third six, bloody credit collection of it.
Version of this figure. I mean,
it's the third credit collection one of it, and it's like it's not even accurate to anything.
It's when I woke up and saw this, I just thought, Jesus, what is going on? It is really depressing.
It doesn't even look good as a reuse of, oh, we've got another Mando. It's like, not in those colors, we don't.
It's kind of sad. It's the death of the Black Series, quite frankly, in my mind. I think they're just killing it slowly.
I think they're doing it faster than slowly. to be honest, it's depressing. And again, it doesn't take a genius to, and again, if this isn't Hasbro and it's Lucasfilm, then shame on them. It doesn't take a genius to deliver this line to collectors. And it's kind of like, where is the difference between Vintage Collection and Black Series? Is it Emily, or is it someone different at Lucasfilm who's doing Vintage Collection, who's not doing Black Series? It's like, how can you not just look over the other side of the fence and go, shit, that's what we should be doing? Like, it's not even, you don't even have to do what the fans want. Just do what your other team's doing. Like, I mean, I can keep crapping on about the fact that we still don't have Lobot, and the Vintage Collection's got him a couple of times. The other ones which came out and were revealed, and just the extras that are coming with Vintage Collection. Like, I mean, again, this is same license, higher price point. It shouldn't be harder for, you know, that example, the Death Trooper that has the flames coming around it and all that stuff.
Yep.
Than the Black Series one or the casing or whatever it is. It's still the same license fee. And then you go, oh, but it's bigger. It's like, yeah, but we pay more. The price is on scale larger to deliver the bigger figure. Therefore, it shouldn't be that the Vintage Collection can get all these new little bits because it's smaller and cheaper. It's like, it's the same license, it's the same figure, and it's comparatively the same price.
I think the thing that... look, personal opinion, everybody's got an opinion, and opinions are like buttholes. But for me, this figure's not even out yet for, I know one or two people have managed to get hold of this in a 6-inch version, but generally no one has this. And to then show another version of it seems really dumb when, you know, because some people may generally prefer this to the regular one. That's fine. If you like this, and go for it. But it just, it feels like something you do maybe a year, year and a half after you've released the figure as a kind of, hey, let's reuse the mold again thing. But it terrifies me that they're then going to do it again in a kind of like silver version and a black
version. They'll bring back the bloody, what was it called? Carbonized version, which will probably look better. But it's just, it is that thing. It's like, this is so boring. And to be honest, I don't even know if I've got anything new to say about the credit collection other than it's boring and it's shit. And it's, if you like it, you like it, cool. But credit collection is even a rung below bloody holiday editions for me.
I think the thing which I find, okay, offended is a strong word, kind of just like, what are you doing? We have, I mean, the whole point of a retro card back is it's the classic retro card back, the original Starfield, you know, to get that kind of vibe. And they continue to get it in 6-inch was great. We kind of got a half-assed collection where we started and then never finished it. Or we're getting bits and pieces here and there. Now they're just full on into this. Let's milk this thing of this credit collection stuff. Which is clearly selling in some capacity, or retailers.
I'm going to go back against them, but it's not, because that second series of credit collections ended up with all the other fan channels because the original sellers of them couldn't move the numbers. Obviously, fan channels were really originally given grief cargo from the second wave. Oh no, sorry, the fan channels were given the Armorer, and then now they've turned up with Grief Karga and someone else a year later because obviously the original partners couldn't sell them. And now we're coming back for a third batch. It's not like even I think the Bo-Katan figure looks fine. It looks good for another Mando, etc. But at the same time, it's like, I don't know. That Bo-Katan's not a hard figure to get.
Exactly.
She got re-released two or three times, and here we are doing more Mando and no Book of Boba Fett. And I didn't even think Book of Boba Fett was the greatest show, but there were some great characters you could have put in there just to world build the collection.
They've screwed the pooch on releasing these figures, some of them too early, in a second version. They screwed the pooch on bastardizing the 40th anniversary card with this dirt retro crap, which is like the awful retro sticker. They've kind of screwed the pooch with these stupid coins. They're not even like the old Power of the Force shiny coins. They're like crap little bits of plastic, which again kind of ruins the whole point of the card because that's more like a Power of the Force card. It's not, oh, I don't know. I just, I'm over it. I just don't like them at all. And again, I think, as you said, they've given yet again all their favoured pals, all the kind of decent stuff in terms of they know it'll be able to sell, and they've utterly flushed the channel with, they've dumped the channel with all the crap they know. Yeah, everybody's sitting on a gazillion Bo-Katans, but let's make that one a fan channel exclusive so we can screw them even more. It's evidently clear what they're doing.
Like, who needs this guy in a credit collection?
Yeah, no. And it's just so minimal a difference. There's just the slight colors and the art they've chosen as well. Not only do we get the Boba Fett's head, yeah, I get it. It's based off the art, but you know, you had the Dark
Trip. But it's not even based off the art. It's the credit art we're looking isn't even from the credit scenes.
No, but you've got, like, Boba Fett, it's the back of his head. You can barely see the character. In the Dark Trooper, you're looking at the side, and you get this really ugly screaming Yoda, baby Grogu there, and it's like, even the card art's like, what are you doing? Just, it's awful. I mean, even this image looks like the, you know, super, super kind of zoomed into picture. Yeah, that kind
looks like put, like they put a, with the greatest of respect of everyone, looks like they put an Instagram filter over the bloody thing.
I don't know what they're doing. I just
Prisma.
So Bo-Katan is another re-release, and you're right, I mean there's a minimal touch there to her. Even the card art looks good there, I think it's, but there's no real color difference to
the only reason why I buy this figure, if I was going to, is because I want the unmasked head to go onto my actual other head because it's got better hair and better
correct
thing. That is the only reason.
Correct. Oh man, I just don't know. I just don't know what they're doing. Ahsoka Tano is another one. Again, a relatively recent figure, which some people have still not yet got. But tweaked. It's like, you know, again, not the worst, but
just not needed.
Really.
We're about to get Ahsoka figures next year. You can redo this figure again next year when we get the TV series.
Yeah, I know. So Axe Wolves is based off the Mandalorian Death Watch, which we knew. And that's fine, looking pretty reasonable. Color's not quite right to my eye. That blue's just like, again, if we look at...
A little bit saturated.
Yeah, it is, and it might be from the images, but yeah, he's a very different color. They've all had some differences in color. I mean, it's close-ish, I guess, but yeah, very, very saturated and popped up on the blue. But look, you know, hey-ho, we're getting the gang completed at last. It doesn't look quite right, but never mind. It's another Mandalorian. But so that's Axe Wolves. We get some nice card shots there,
which kind of suggests he's going to be in the one of the waves anyway. There's a wave at the moment which still has one figure to reveal what it's going to be.
Yeah,
but this looks like it's the last plastic bubble. So surprise!
No, why is it top secret when it comes down to waves? I don't know. So here we go. The I can't remember the exact name for this, but yeah, Halloween Trooper. Reusing the Maz Kanata little chest piece with a Jabba the Hutt ghost on it and a zombie porg. Christ, we're stretching things here. You know, as a fun thing... it's okay, but
I don't mind it compared to the Christmas ones, but I'm just still like, this is where we are. That's just where I am. I'm just like, really, we've gone here again, and you can't give us regular troopers released in fan channels as, you know, Clone Trooper Phase 2 clear all the time, every time, and here's a few paint variants. Like, we get Halloween Troopers.
I know. I don't think they've given a shot of inside the box, but I don't think they've changed it from before, which was just a bunch of stuff in a lightsaber. But they've then just, pardon me, chucked in some loose credit collection stuff. It just, again, it feels like, yeah, that'll do the perceived value again. It's pretty shocking. Pretty shocking, I have to say. This is where we are. God, when you think back to the original Black Series figures, the Luke, Maul, Han, just what the promise was for this line and this farcical Poundland Dollar General type vibe we've got going on now. You just all this time of collecting, and this is what you feel you're left with. It's just like really not
what
great.
What was the other one? Some it was the werewolf, Black Crusader.
Yeah. I think that was on another page. Let me just lightsabers. Well, I think it's there. I've got it in another one of the other tabs, but Yeah, that is. There's another one, as you said, the Black Chrysanthemum one. I'll show that in just a sec. But we had some lightsabers. We also had some Gaming Greats reveals. No surprise there in terms of repaints on the Battle Droid. Oof, we're now fourth, maybe fifth version, which is fine, but it's getting a little bit like...
Look, obviously there's something to do with Battle Droids in Jedi...
Mm.
Fallen Jedi, whatever.
Jedi Fallen Order.
No, Jedi Survivor, sorry.
Oh, Jedi Survivor. My apologies. My apologies, that's right. Yeah, you're getting the figures before they're revealed.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And on the same figure again that you've seen before. So, again, solid build, but new packaging, which I quite like personally. Getting a repaint of K2SO, which is now KX Security Droid. Big backpack. Try and get that effort to stand. And that's the reused electro prod, cattle prod from the Scout repaint. It's the reuse of on a repaint retool of the repainted retooled Biker Scout. Wow. We're in the metaverse indeed. Some people like this. It's okay.
Look, if you like it, go for it.
Exactly.
I've just got a budget that can do better things.
I think it's really, I mean, this is what they're doing is, I think, and now really just highlighting the budget where people are like, well, I'm not buying that again, essentially. And I mean, again, it's not as if this is, you could have probably bought a budget K2SO and fudged some backpack and some paint, and you know, you could almost kind of redo it yourself. That's what it feels like. Again, it's not like they're adding any major value here. It is very much perceived value here.
And at the moment, I'm just assuming it's a it's just another thing to fight and battle, not an actual character.
Yep. Now this, I believe, when I looked at the price point, was a lower price by...
Really?
I think it was $4 or $5.
I'm going to look it up so that we can...
Please do. Because if not, wow. That is...
This is the $10 figure where we're paying potentially $15 for the crib.
Yeah.
Pending final price, but I'm looking it up now.
So new thing in this pack appears to be...
Nope, the little $24.99.
Oh, goddamn, he's full price. Yeah, so again, it's the
$10 for, but it's $10 for literally the crib, which was an add-on in the first Mando Deluxe, whatever it was, just painted differently. And same then Grogu. A medallion, different Grogu, but still, it was previously a $8.99 or $7.99 figure. So we're now paying $24 for the necklace and the crib, but the crib itself was previously released with a deluxe Mando.
You know, credit to them. This will sell because it's Grogu, even though the shelves are beginning to get a little bit full of Grogu. It'll sell. But it feels a bit rubbish.
Do you know what's happening in Australia, though? At least for the first time ever in what this started in 2013. So we're coming up to the ninth year. We're about to hit the 10th year next year. For the first time ever, we are starting to see, like they do in the States, price variations. Like you'll walk into a Zing now and they've got the original Knight Brother at $35. This is all Australian, down from $55. They have Rampart at $29, down from $55, and they have the regular figures at $45, the non-exclusives at $45. But you're seeing different figures being priced differently now with this time thing because they're both flooding and they're not selling. And it's the first time. I think the Knight Brothers are some of the better Gaming Great figures.
Sure.
They're cool from Jedi Fallen Order, and they're also particularly potentially army builders. But I think that even it shows that you could sell more crap previously of repaints than you could get away with now. And you've got cost of living, you've got interest rates, you've got
recessions,
you've got all these things, and you've also got less money in pocket from the government whilst we're all going through lockdowns and shit. But it's just like, you know, you can announce 40 figures, and if 30 of them are shit, they're going to sit on shelves more now than ever before.
Yep. No, I agree. It's
it really comes down to figure selection at the moment, and that's what they're still failing on.
So, yeah. So I said earlier on the slow death of the Black Series, and you said maybe not so slow. So let's call it the acceleration of the death of the Black Series. Oh my God, it's just pitiful. Anyway, new figure of sorts, I think. Pretty much mostly new. HK87. Not a version I remember at all of HK87.
Who is HK87?
Maybe I'm getting confused with the KOTOR droid. HK87 Star Wars. Let's see what we've got. The assassin, right? Sorry, I'm getting it confused. Yes, HK47. My apologies, that's what I'm thinking of. This is the classic HK47 from KOTOR, Knights of the Old Republic.
Yeah,
so I guess they're using the figure to then redo. I didn't realize that assassin droid there. And
that's literally who it is. Okay, gotcha.
Yeah. Yeah, so they've reused parts of that, which again was inspired, as you can see there, by the old Ralph McQuarrie-esque original IG-88 drawing that was. So it's all connected in some ways. But yeah, that's exactly what that is. So you'll get the lower half of that body and or part, and then you'll get the HK-47, which I think they teased or the pipelined or something at one point.
I think they've pipelined it.
Yeah, he's a very, very popular Knights of the Old Republic droid because he's a sarcastic dude. That's nice. Fair enough. Interesting kind of figure. Not really for me, but still kind of interesting.
Look, and I appreciate that it's going into that, what we like to call the deep dive, which isn't really the world building of the Mandalorian, which is good, but it's, again, you'll use a new sculpt for that, but you won't make, and you'll sculpt new pieces for that, but you won't make Republic Commandos out of new sculpts. So, again, it's just these crazy things that keep making it sad, and we're just talking about toys, but it's just
I know exactly. We wish no one any harm anywhere at Hasbro or Lucasfilm, unlike some fans, but we're just passionate about the line. That's all. Star Wars The Mandalorian Luke's appearance at the end of the season or the series, series two.
So there's a problem with this,
which is.
The robe. That's a Return of the Jedi robe on the front of the cover of the Mandalorian one. Then you look at the robe he's got as the figure. That's Return of the Jedi. That's Mandalorian. I'm just, you know, it's really simple. It feels to me like that's the Return of the Jedi box for the figure that they were meant to be getting with the with the Rancor, which was going to be on a card, and this was going to be the boxed version, and they've gone, oh, yeah, here you go. Here's the Mandalorian artwork. It's like, same figure, different hood, and we've got it wrong.
Well, I think what they've went for is a slightly different facial sculpt so they can then retool it more to be more Return of the Jedi maybe later on. I don't know. Kind of weird, grumpy face, but hey-ho. They never get Luke right. It's always really hard for some reason. Nailed Han. And I think the Luke from Endor, I thought, was pretty
The face was, sure, yeah. And even the face of the other Return of the Jedi one was not bad in certain angles. But look, was it Mafex most recently that nailed it?
See, almost why did they... Why really change what is pretty much a doable face sculpt?
There? Yeah, just change the hair.
Why, it doesn't have the helmet. Brand new head? Why make a brand new head for that figure? When you could kind of, you could have got away with that personally. It could have been.
Just fix the hair up. But just fix the hair up. And it's like, you've got the face sculpt there to reuse rather than change it again. And again, sometimes our 6-inch heads are looking more like 375 and our 375s are looking more 6-inch. Again, what's happening on the other side of the fence?
Just weird. Anyway, moving on, Max Mayfield in his first version.
Appearance.
Yeah.
It's fine. I'm good with it.
Yeah, I like it. All the guns, all the parts, all the pieces. Reuse the head. Why not? Looks, makes sense. Yeah. Max Mayfield. All good. No issues there whatsoever. Probably will sell well because he's got lots of guns. So they kind of had to do all this but I think, truthfully, I think if they could away with it, they would have charged this a deluxe because the minute they lay out things in a box like that, they're like, we could make this a deluxe.
If only he had a rifle, that would have been...
Yeah, exactly, it would have been like, yeah, or a blast effect or something. Oh, he's deluxe. Really? But yeah, look, not looking too bad. Looking pretty good. They've kind of tidied the face up from the other version, it seems. Slightly, maybe paint. Here we go. Here's the other Wookiee Halloween edition. So basically, Black Kristan, the repaint with a new head. Jesus.
Let's not spend too much time on this one.
Wow. Just wow. This is where we're at, folks. Goddamn. Ooh, yeah, let's just move on. Nice touch on the little fangs on the Jedi Fallen Order piece. Yeah, I get it. It just sucks. Do you know, in some ways, if you took the ears off, it looks like a better head than the Black Kristan.
Yeah.
Which is weird.
In other ways, it looks like Michael Jackson from the Thriller movie. So let's move on. That's just scary.
Yes. Perceived value comes with bits of plastic, aka credit stuff. And yeah, there's your perceived value there. There we go. We're into vintage. Let's just, for time's sake, skip that. Although it looks bloody wonderful, it has to be said. Some of the figures there. Again, for a 3.75-inch figure, it's... in some ways, almost better than the shiny kind of stuff that we're getting on the 6-inch stuff. So we got a Cal, just again, just to show off the Cal Kestis in Jedi Survivor in Vintage Collection. No sign of that. And I mean, again, why wouldn't you announce that in black? Oh my God. Anyway, it looks great in Vintage. Let's see what that turns out like in 6-inch. Just doesn't make sense to do it in one scale and not the other. And a Clatoonian guard, which again, really again, should probably end up in the Black Series at some point. But then it's mostly new sculpt there, so might not. Anyway, so Vintage Collection's doing great, and they had a Jedi look. Let's actually have a look at the 3.75 inch. The facial sculpt is better than the 6-inch.
Yeah.
What is going on, Black Series team? That looks better than the 6-inch version.
Yeah.
Don't understand that. Don't understand why that is happening. So, yes, that was a bunch of figures there revealed. We've just kind of ran through. I think for Star Wars, there was a little bit more.
I can do some rattling off, which we don't need to look at, which is the pipelines. Yeah. And so the pipeline reveals... was you can tell me what's Conehead Jedi
Ki-Adi-Mundi.
Ki-Adi-Mundi. It's a brand new Mandalorian retool, a completely brand new Mando. Hopefully they get the scale of the helmet absolutely perfect 15th time round. And it is a completely new Book of Boba Fett appearance of Black Chrysanthemum.
Yes, I saw that, yep.
So then the other things they revealed were the Return of the Jedi 40th anniversary figures. And so just quickly, I will rattle them. There was two deluxe ones being Boba Fett and the Rebel Trooper. And then for the standard 10 cards so far revealed, we're going to get new figure being Wicket, the Ewok. I guess we're getting Endor Leia again, Endor Han again, Bib Fortuna again, the Emperor again. Hopefully with this one they go with the Amazon Emperor.
You'd hope.
Rather than the putting the archive version back in 6 months later.
Never say never.
We get a Paplu back after being the Heroes of Endor set. So technically I call that a new figure, even though it's not, but it was only Comic-Con, so that's a new release. We get a Lando after the archive release of him in disguise. We get a Chewbacca again, so hopefully they give us like the chain around the neck or something, because I think that's the photo they used. We've got a Biker Scout, and thankfully we've got a Stormtrooper.
Woohoo! We get a Stormtrooper. Which they'll give all the stock to Amazon and they'll cancel all the orders again like they did in the last wave.
So the thing that's missing again is you want to make collectors happy. Make them happy by, in Return of the Jedi 40th anniversary, giving us some Jabba. Gang. Prune face, squid face, wee quees, bloody... all those skiff guard things, like, just give us those guys. And you want to go deep on the Mandalorian with HK-87. Next year, go deep on Return of the Jedi with figures that were released by Kenner that it's so easy. And you can reuse pieces. You could reuse half of Obi-Wan for the skiff guards from the Obi-Wan Kenobi blue. Let me cut some tuna outfit. That's one of the skiff guards, and just give it its head and hands.
A lot of those figures you're mentioning there, they feel like a respectable time since the figure was released. So it kind of goes back to that point I made earlier on about the Dark Trooper, where the Dark Trooper comes out and it's not even out, or it's revealed when it's not even come out. Whereas the Endor set has been out. It's going to be some time.
Lando's another bloody. That's the late. Lando is lazy. If they reuse the Emperor from the archive and not the Amazon Emperor, which was more superior, then it's lazy again to have put it on card. And then 6 months later, it's Return of the Jedi.
There's sadly really nothing tremendously new in that bunch of figures. They're all re-releases of some
Just Wicket.
Well, yeah, because Paplu has been out before technically. Yeah, so Wicket.
But Wicket and Paplu.
Yeah. And it's a kind of lazy way when they really could have done a bit more, you know, at least in some of the other waves they'd kind of chucked in maybe a...
And here's the other thing.
A newer figure.
Rancor didn't fund.
Yep.
So if you're going to put them on a vintage card,
yep,
it's Power of the Force and it's with a coin. It's with a 6-inch coin. But no, give us some shitty credit collection coin and don't give us a really good bloody Return of the Jedi coin or whatever it is. So it's like, you know, anyway.
It's such a hard line to collect. My favorite line is the 40th anniversary collection. And, you know, I could be dead by the time they actually get around to releasing a reasonable quantity of them. They're just taking so long to do it. And they could be churning this stuff out fine. Every month there could be a 40th anniversary figure at the fan channel.
They could be doing... Remember how last year with Marvel, there was the Marvel Mondays?
Yeah.
And once a month, every Marvel, it was a repainted figure on a retro card or a re-released BAF in a packet. It could just be Star Wars Sundays. I don't know. I'm not a marketing guy. Star Wars Sundays reveal the bloody vintage figure. One a month, therefore we get 12 more vintage cards figures. It's separate from any mainline. Just put it out on the fan channels. Once a month, the fan channels get a new retro card. It's like, again, guys, it's not hard. This is what's killing me. It's not hard to rip us off with repaints and repacks and throw in a couple of new ones in between and actually make us happy about it than make us scratch our heads and say what?
I know. Anyway, so I think that was it for Star Wars overall. There was a lot of stuff. But let's quickly look at what is also a lot of stuff on the... Now, there was Black Panther Wave, which was revealed. I'm going to skip them because they're really at retail anyway, and they've been hitting stores in many cases. Not that Black Panther Wave. Ignore them. They're out in stores. There was another wave of Black Panther figures just for pure... completeness, there you go. There's a whole bunch.
I'm just going to be quick. There's the wave, and I'm just the only one I'm getting is the comic Black Panther.
Same. It's the only one I wait for, but nice enough wave. Nothing wrong with it, but you can literally go and pre-order them right now. So go and have a look at them, and we'll see more of it with Wakanda Forever coming up.
And technically, by buying one of them, you get your Tim from The Office figure.
You do indeed. So yeah, so that is them. We'll skip that because again, you can just go and pre-order right now. The other figures, one of the reveal on the Marvel side was because the show starts any day, is She-Hulk, which I thought was a phenomenal looking figure, really well pulled together, looking really really good from the show actually.
I think she looks incredible, and I'm going to watch the show. I'm not hanging for it, but I'm going to watch it. I don't really care for all the hate that's going on for it. I'm kind of like, I'll just watch it. I'll watch everything. CGI, I'm kind of like, I don't actually think the Hulk CGI is that good. So her CGI, I'm not that offended by it again. It is what it is. I think this figure is one of the best sculpted figures that we've got in a good year or so. It looks identical. It really just does. Looks like what I've seen on the screen so far for her. And the face is, put it with Gamora, maybe the best faces are green.
Yes, I agree. It is I knocked it at the park in that show. They really have. Pretty phenomenal, has to be said. Pretty phenomenal. So anyway, looking forward to that one.
So that will round out the Disney Plus wave.
Correct. Which is a nice... God, I can see the way they do this with like one figure from... it's really painful. But hey-ho, I understand.
Heaven forbid you should buy each of those as they've revealed them with other things and then have them all held until the one complete wave is... It's... Anyway.
Moving on. So, yes, the rest of the Marvel stuff we'll basically quickly go over here. And let us... Yeah, some good stuff. Some fun reveals, that's for sure. Let's quickly share that. There we go. That's better. I'm sharing a little better now, learning this. We have an Amazon pack. This is the one that sold out in literally an hour, where we've got Agony, basically a Scream repaint.
I think so, yeah.
Looking good though. I love all the Venom collection. I'm really not so fast. I quite like them all. This is actually a little bit mixed up. So there's the Black Panther, the comic one.
I love this. This is the one I love.
Richard E. Grant, it's pretty good. He's got his sludge green in his fingers, looking pretty good. White Black Panther.
He remains.
A.K.A. what's his name?
Kang.
Kang, thank you. Kang the Conqueror. Looking good. Howard the Duck with
Ant-Man.
Right. Okay, that's right. This is from What If.
Yeah.
Not Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Meta. The Human Fly, looking good.
Fly Guy.
Fly Guy, yes. I need to get that one. Fly Guy looks as if he needs the toilet, that's for sure. It's screaming.
See, this is the one which I think is cool, but
that's got a two-power booster, I believe.
Oh, well, there you go. Same. I'm still like, yeah.
A couple of cheap low paint ones to do, but yeah, if you like them. Beast is getting repackaged again in his classic kind of, not in the VHS packaging, it has to be said.
I was convinced this was the VHS release.
Me too.
And they were packing it all, and I'm like, they're going, we're getting on the retro card. And I was like, convinced we'd got on the retro card, but the gray one came on the retro card. So now we're getting the blue one on the retro card. And this is the gray version in blue with a jacket and an extra beaker.
And I guarantee you it will be cel-shaded for the VHS release.
Yep.
And a very fat VHS box, but yes.
I guarantee I'm going to have both.
Correct. Don't miss out on a Blue Beast because he was a fortune before. And it's now got some nice stuff with the
lab. It's got a better kind of color mix as well.
It does. Better perceived value on this one. That was a
Fan Channel
release, I believe, common release. I don't think it was exclusive. But that looks great. Really good. X-Men figures never disappoint. Generally don't disappoint in the Marvel Legends line. So that was a fan pleaser. There we go on the retro card. If you like that retro card. Lizard was a Walmart exclusive. Scorpion, sorry. My apologies, Lizard. Lizard was a Walmart exclusive, though.
It was.
So,
and he's also green.
And it's also green. And they're keeping it Walmart in the Walmart family. So Scorpion, yes. Repainting the previous... Was that game deco on the previous one?
No, it was all green and shiny. And he had the mouth was green as well. This has got the cutout face.
That's right.
This is cool. I would like to have this version of the face on the other figure.
On the other one, yeah.
It's a little too lime green for me. I know it's the animated series, but I like my Scorpion to have the face showing. Yeah. But I prefer the other green. This looks a bit Masters of the Universe.
That mouthy look is not great. Anyway, Aho would have been better with a smile, I think. Maybe that's what they were going for, but so Scorpion, this, I have to say, was a real downer for the Marvel Legends team. I guess what was on the meeting that day was, how do we get to reuse the Tesseract? Which they previously had lumped in with Red Skull. They have now lumped it in with a retooled head, still not got a great likeness, Tom Hiddleston figure. I would have liked that figure, but I'm not buying the bloody Tesseract again.
Just looks out of proportion.
Yeah, it's just not right. It's the suit body with Loki. Yeah, it's not right. It's not right. And the Tesseract again, which was the silly thing to make. And to repack it again with Loki is just smells clearance to me. But we'll see. It will not sell well, I don't think. Who the hell is Razorback? This is just... What?
This is deep dive. I believe, if I'm not mistaken... This is an Arkansas villain, and they got Robo to. He'd been asking for whatever it was his up on stage to have his moment with it. Not that he wanted to be up on stage or in front of them with it, Paul, but it is a deep dive Spider-Man figure that I don't need, but I'm happy for those who've got it.
Wow. Just wow. Just wow.
Again, that has new sculpt on it. That has new sculpt on it. It would never be reused ever again.
Wow. Anyway, this was part of the Amazon exclusive, sold in an hour, Marvel Legends
Venom pack.
This is Riot in these colors, aka the Venom sculpt, or Monster Venom sculpt retweet, with a different arm or swap out arm. Nice, look great. It's a Venom character, looks good. Sentry finally gets an upgrade and gets a haircut. He's been to Jennifer Aniston's barber, I think.
I like that Sentry.
Yeah, like some people love Sentry. I just think he looks like a bit of a dick. But Banana Man, quite frankly, a bright yellow spandex. I don't understand the ghost face. I don't know what that is relevant to. But I wasn't aware Sentry had a face peel option, but there we go.
It's the John Carpenter of Bay version.
So there we go. That was a bunch of Marvel Legends figures. I think I had a little bit more. Let me just double check the...
There's a Spider-Man.
Spider-Man, thank you. Yes, that's what I was going to do. There was a little bit more here, actually. Let me share.
And yeah, you've got the Spider-Man file.
There we go. Showing a little better. Just to pick up, we didn't see this in those images there. The Heralds of Galactus, that was a two-pack as well. I don't know whether that's fully shaped. No, that's not properly shaped.
They're Pulse exclusives. Oh, no, we can see it. I can see it. I can see the file.
Yeah, like not the full version. It's not sharing it properly. Let me share screen. Just share the entire screen. And then you should see what I was doing there, which is no.
Yeah. No, I can see that now. Yeah.
Yep. The two-pack there of this. These two
perfect figures. For guys who have the Galactus.
Yep. And that's a repaint of an old BAF, I believe. I think it was a BAF way back. I remember having it at one point. Maybe tarted up with some bits and pieces, but ultimately reused. The old spiral effect never dies. Very simple figure for them to make in some ways, the clear plastic and just the one color. Hence why Marvel Legends maybe can do lots of different things. In the box. What's going on? That's all the figures we've covered already, I think. Yeah, including Pigface. In the Venom pack, we never got a look at the all of the figures. So we had Agony and Riot. I don't think it had... There we go. There's the Venom itself. So the... not the Monster Venom. The comic...
This is the animated cell shaded retro Venom that was a exclusive to someone.
Yep.
Some kind of con exclusive, I can't remember.
Yeah, it was a PulseCon?
Yeah.
Fabulous.
The Omega Red Body, and they've filled the holes in, which is great. And I think they're Harding Studios sculpts of the new Venom head, which are just awesome.
Mm.
Like, I mean, as I was just saying off camera, I don't have the Lasher. Is it Lasher? Was that the black one with the green slimy thing? The Future Foundation? So I can't complete this team. And so the only
thing
I want Venom.
It's just, it's irritating again. Of course they make it an exclusive, but had they made a fan channel, it would still be selling every day. But it's sold out, so they've lost sales.
Mm.
They're making less money. They have to be. It just does not make sense. Jesus. There's the box art. Marvel, Riot, Agony. Won't be the last time you see that Venom. You will get it again, but again, just frustrating. When people just want to click and buy something and you can't. It's just garbage. It's just garbage to not have it available right now to buy. It doesn't make any sense. They could be... Ah, never mind. What do you do with Hasbro? There's not a lot you can do. They just start a world into their own. So a bunch of other figures as well. There was a retro Spidey revealed, this a retro packaging version blue Spidey. Basically a repaint of one of the recent figures with a head tweak, I think.
Head tweak, yeah.
But apart from that, not a great deal of difference from before.
Except it's the right Spider-Man blue, which we have not got for years. Do you know the only Spider-Man figure in my memory to have this blue correct? The six-armed Spider-Man.
Yes, that's right. Mm.
Everything else is the wrong blue to me. This is the right blue. It self-shaded it, but, you know.
You can see the wrong blue there. Yeah.
I love that. So I don't love the self-shading. I love the blue and the red. It's 100% my Spider-Man.
Yep.
Hopefully, maybe you could paint wash off, like with some kind of paint stripper, the self-shading and the blue plastics underneath it.
It's still not right, is it? Anyway. So we have Spidey's Friends, a re-release of Firestar, a re-release of Iceman, so really, the retro card.
So the differences are that Firestar now has pinless arms and legs, which she didn't have on the other one. She has a animated face, not a comic face.
Yep.
Spidey is one of the other bodies without the articulated toes and a different head again.
Yep.
And Iceman is a re-release of the previous Iceman, but cel-shaded.
And a new head, by the looks of it.
Possibly.
I think. I may be wrong, but...
it's a good three-pack, but it's a Pulse exclusive.
Yeah, again, it's like, what? Yeah. With Pucci. Yes, so... It's so hard keeping track of what the hell they're doing and where it is and when you can buy it. Oh, it's sold out. It's just, what a cluster. Everything's just a cluster. But anyway, Spider-Man and Amazing Friends, nicely done. Touch to the animated series. It's a nice picture there in the back, actually. All digitally rendered, never mind, but still, nonetheless. And there's more of the Scorpion picks, which I think we covered. This was the other pack that was announced just before the con. The No Way Home, again, Hasbro Pulse 3 pack. Criminal, this was a...
Just the like fourth biggest or fifth biggest movie of all time. Just the biggest Marvel standalone movie of all time. Just a franchise that spans 9 different movies. But yeah, why not make it an exclusive to America, UK, and Germany?
Nuts. Absolutely nuts. I don't understand them at all. Amazing looking figures. There's a lot of detail in these. They talked about the raised ribbing of the outfit, which we understand that kept that pushed costs up.
That's the winner. It's the Andrew Garfield one is the best. All new sculpt. He looks awesome. As for the other one, I've already got him painted with webs.
Yeah, it's just slightly different, but not much in the head, I think.
And the hands. Look, you were getting 3 sets of hands. I remember saying everything I wanted from these 3 if they're going to make them again and whatever else. And we got all but one part of it, which is the unmasked heads.
Mm.
But SH Figure Arts and Hot Toys have unmasked heads, so it's not a licensing issue. Somebody pay the license to the actors.
Yeah.
So we'll probably get them now released then as individual figures, non-Pulse exclusives with unmasked heads, but not 3 sets of hands you watch. I guarantee you the web-crawling hands will disappear and the unmasked heads will show up.
Yeah, we know Hasbro's tricks. One of the things they also announced, and we kind of skimmed by it and I mentioned it briefly but never really showed it, was the Selfie series. Which was available at Hasbro, the Hasbro booth at San Diego Comic-Con, I think, to pre-order there. From that point on, I think it's, again, Pulse you got it. I'm not quite sure. We'll find it more.
It's going to be Pulse later in the year. I reckon that PulseCon will launch it.
Mm.
And then it's for PulseCon peeps.
So the
Hasbro Pulse members.
So the figures revealed, there's one there, which is
Scarlet
from G.I. Joe, so that there's a G.I. Joe flavor to it. There's also Power Rangers, as you can see there, and Power Rangers again, and I think there's a Ghostbusters one, yep. So, yeah, clearly the idea is... Sorry, go ahead.
Legends and Star Wars as well, somewhere.
Yeah, Marvel. Yeah, they didn't show that in the press images, though. I noticed that.
They did. They did do a Star Wars one. They had.
Didn't look great. These are obviously the press photos, but maybe you've got it in your Insta. We can have a quick look at it. I don't know.
Yeah, I've got it somewhere.
I have to say the selfie series I saw non press photos didn't kind of like work for me. Clearly there's a resemblance, but it wasn't like, wow, must have. Looked a little 3D printy to me.
Which is what it is.
It is, but...
They're not sending it to a factory.
Correct. But these look to be a little different, a little tarted up maybe for the final... Anywho, that's primarily the majority of figures. Where's Matt's looking at something else? I think what we can quickly do is maybe have a look at your Star Wars page.
We can probably skip Joe because it was just really
there wasn't.
There was lots of renders. There was lots of coming figures.
We should...
but I don't know where they are. I think 2D Sculpts has them on their page.
I did actually have a G.I. Joe little look there. Bear with me.
Let's just talk about the characters that were revealed with the images rather than give them too much depth.
Yeah, there were some nice shots, though, very quickly, of that the Serpentor and the... let's have a look. And the Mindbender. Mindbender was at the release... or reveal. Where are we? Serpentor. Jesus, so much stuff at San Diego Comic Con. It was just insane. I think everybody kept everything for long enough that they wanted to. There we go. Quick look at this. And the panels were good too. There's a lot of information they revealed at the show in the panels. Very, 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 very quickly. Low light Cobra Flight. Copperhead. There we go. Sneak peeks. Oops. Copperhead. Low light Cobra Flight pod with Telly Viper. The Crimson Guard. Retro Cardback Snake Eyes, which was also revealed and was up for a pre-order and gone really quickly, was Retro Storm Shadow. Rock and Roll, Serpent in his box. We'll see a picture of that in a minute. That was at the panel. Here's Lenny and Co. doing the Serpentor reveal. And I think there was some other press picks in
there. Was some pictures of, like, if you go to 2D Sculpt, I think his name is on Instagram. He does the renders and he's got like Shipwreck and all that stuff.
What was the name? Sorry, 2D.
2D Sculpt.
SC. Yeah, 2D there Sculpt. Yeah, you can see that there. So, yeah, there we go. Perfect. Yeah.
It's actually not all of them. No, it doesn't have Shipwreck there.
Let's just get the picks. Just to be Second tour. Here we go, some booth picks. Yeah, that'll do. So yeah, came out and revealed on his big chariot, and just looked pretty stunning, to be honest. I don't know why they didn't send us press picks of that when they sent them to other places. Yeah, huge box, Mindbender size box, and that's going back into some other retro.
There you go. There's Shipwreck. There's the Shipwreck render.
Picks there. It's a pretty stunning chariot, really pretty stunning indeed. And if you thought Mindbender was over the top, then, well, Serpentine is even more with all the detail and the vehicle and the, yeah.
So this is another Pulse exclusive.
Mm-hmm. So, and Mindbender went up for reveals. So there's a lot of G.I. Joe stuff going on there. Good God, there's a lot of stuff there. Just talking about the Crimson Guards. No, thank you. Yeah, he's done a good coverage of that. Toyhabits.com. So, yes, there was a lot of reveals, but not a great deal of press stuff they sent out for G.I. Joe. So, yeah, I think that's probably the very top highlights of it all. Anything on your page, we think?
There's lots in the last month.
I know.
It's been more, probably 6-inch Legends been kicking some ass. The photography in the Marvel world at the moment is killing it.
Mm.
It always kills it in Star Wars, but like with the line, I feel like there's less of a vibe going on.
Mm. The new Boba Fett's not bad. I'm actually quite impressed with him. He's not as bad as I thought he was going to be.
Yeah.
So there's still the in-between version we haven't quite got, I believe, which is the really...
He's due soon.
Isn't he? Yeah.
Yeah, he's due soon.
Stop.
That's just that? That's all the bunch of assholes are putting bloody death threats and abuse on online retailers.
Yeah.
As if they're responsible for the delays and just sitting on people's stock.
So one thing I've still never understood is why fans seem to think it's toy stores that are sitting on their figures. What kind of mental capacity have you got? Do you not understand if they don't have it?
Brain dead F-wits. I'm sorry. That's what they are. And, you know, let's keep some perspective. We've spoken an hour and 20 minutes about toys at the moment. We're talking about toys, whether we like them, love them, disappointed them, whatever it is. They're friggin' toys.
I know.
Abuse people, you don't bloody death threat them, you don't whatever. Like, sometimes Dorks I get something before BBTS, sometimes BBTS gets it before Walmart, sometimes somebody gets it before the other, and sometimes Australia gets it before all of you. There is no control over the Hasbro distribution system that online retailers have.
I think it's the Marvel Legends Winter Soldier. I saw here in January. I could have bought it.
Yeah.
I only just got it the other day from my US retailer. And I'm like, from Darkseid. That's when they got the stock. BBTS get the stock same day. So 6 months. I mean, it's weird how the delays are affecting some things. Look, there's a bunch of incredible photography here. Tarkin, what a great shot of a figure. Escape Toy Picks. Just the lighting, the tunneling.
Backdrop. And
backdrop, just beautiful. And lots of other reveals and things we talked about. Yeah, that was another reveal as well as the Endor Deluxe Trooper. That's more newish.
Yeah.
That's cool. So that will be a nice reveal to see in time. And
just to remind you though, the Hoth Trooper was a mainline, not a deluxe. It had three different faces, different weapons, scarves, fitted into a little box.
Mm-hmm.
So just we'll see what this deluxe one has.
True. Perceived value. Well, it might be completely different heads because the other one just had a beard and non-beard, and it was really the mask that made the difference, whereas they could make it deluxe by having just 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, the supposedly Rex dude, there's a kind of gingery version person, and a black guy who've all been kind of made by Hasbro in Vintage Collection. So, anywho, Wicket Pablu, that's a nice reveal. We talked about all of these, I think, pretty much. That was another figure that kind of fell between cracks a little bit prior to the show we did last night. B, I think.
We did, didn't we? We talked about it being alien like lift loader.
That's right. Stormtrooper, again, the man the packaging. That's a nice repaint of
it's beautiful.
That is beautiful. Way to go. I mean, again, this is, see the difference, the three stripes, the two stripes. So I'm waiting for Hasbro to which they could easily do, but they haven't done as yet. One stripe, two stripe, three stripe.
No. They can save it and three stripe it with all that horrible shit over it for a credit collection.
No, I'd buy them all. One stripe, two stripe, three stripe. Love it. This is the way indeed, and the rare repaint there. So good job. That's a really nice facial sculpt on. Wow.
It is.
Way better than the one we got. Damn. Nice job, Fat Clone. I do love the Boba in that outfit. It really is a great figure. And screams in some ways deluxe in Hasbro's mind because of this pack-ins and the stuff they've got.
That was always the irony, that one was mainline and the other one was deluxe.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. Really does. Oh my God, we could be here all day. Lovely framing in the shot there of the lightsabers with Grievous, Star Wars Rick, looking great. Vader in the rain, looking awesome as well. Guillaume GH4, the new Boba, Ahsoka with the cape, looking good. Oh my God, there's tons of stuff. Let's get a quick look at your Marvel page. So again, Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries is Matt's page, but 6-inch Legends is his Marvel stuff. And there's some good looking stuff on those pages. Yeah, you're right. It's Marvel's killing it. How much do you love your cyborg Spidey now? I love him now.
He's the best.
Hated him before. I thought, ugh.
Now, when I'm in Canada next month, I'll see if I can find a couple more in shelves at retail price and not shipped and everything else that we have to go through.
Spider Punk, which is going to be in the Spider Verse, isn't it? I think that was the.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I'd read as well. Makes sense. Lots of great picks, lots of great black. You can always be guaranteed a recent pick of a black Spidey in here somewhere. Looking good. Namor, which we got revealed in the Wakanda trailer. Nice. The two Todd McFarlane eyes. Very nice. Kisu Creations. It's a bunch of stuff on these pages. Instagram.com/6inchlegends. How good do they look? Even the dodgy head Hulk. And we're getting more Daredevil. We get plenty of good Marvel stuff to come. That is for sure. And lots more Spideys to come. Oh my God, what a killer repaint. Why have Hasbro not done that?
I don't know.
I mean, I would. I would have done that in a heartbeat. Anything you think we've kind of missed over? It's been a bit of a long setup in the show for you.
I don't think so.
Great figures, great photographs, definitely.
There's the Spider-Mans are starting to pop up, like the Iron Spider and stuff, for different people in different countries.
Yes.
So go out and abuse your local retailers for not having them for you. Just kidding.
Yeah.
You know, this is the perfect example. Some people have it, some will have to wait. It's.
Yeah, I just saw it in the UK when I went, the Null and Venom 2-pack, as I said to you, but it's not due for another couple of months at US retail.
And not till October or something for Amazon.
Yeah. So that's what we talked about with She-Hulk. and just more written as Richard E. Grant, looking good.
Smiling face, it's brilliant.
No.
Secret Wars is coming.
You see, 18
episodes of Daredevil in Born Again.
I know, it's fantastic. There was another figure that went with Fly Guy. I thought it was Booster. Maybe I'm thinking of DC. Yeah, we pretty much covered. Was this it? No.
No, that's just the Vulcan, the new body.
And the Spidey we talked about. Yes, plenty of stuff going on there. So, San Diego Comic-Con, pretty much a hit for Marvel. Pretty solid. Star Wars, you're on timeout. You need to rethink your options and go home. And
just speak to your vintage collection team, please. Please.
Exactly. I think that wraps it up. We will see for episode 116 coming up soon. And apologies if there was any little errors in the show sharing or whatever, but we'll get them resolved and we'll see you for the next episode.
Sweet.
See ya.
See ya.